Hey everyone, it's Scott from CertMedia.com, and in this video I'm going to be showing you how to make your cart and checkout pages in WooCommerce look a little bit more modern and a little bit more like Shopify. So everybody here is probably familiar with what Shopify is. It's the second largest CMS in the world right now, and it's very widely used for small businesses to produce their online stores. However, you've chosen WooCommerce probably because you're a WordPress fanatic. And you want to get a little bit of influence of Shopify design in your WooCommerce site. And you can actually do that relatively easily. It can work with any theme in theory. You may have styles that override it and you may have to correct those. But for most people, it should be a very simple insert the code and it will work. So I'm going to show you what the current cart and checkout pages look like and what they can look like. And then I'm going to show you how to actually implement it. And I'm going to go over some of the cool things that you can enable through these new cart and checkout pages. So this is your basic cart page found in WooCommerce. It says cart and it's basic. It's basically the same that it's always been. If you have a customized theme like Avada, it will have a customized, nice, stylish cart page that their own developers have worked with. But this is the general storefront theme. This is how it's going to look for most themes out of the box. It's not that attractive. It's frankly a little hard to follow because all the information is so spread out without really giving you what's important. And the fact that your actual cart totals, this is on a 1920 by 1080 resolution display, and it's for a 27-inch monitor. That's what I have the my current monitor parameter to. And as you can see, the checkout button is almost completely off the screen. And that's the next logical course of action. This is something that Shopify did better at, is it had a clean, this is what you have, and this is what you're going to go to next to actually complete your checkout process. Now, this is what it looks like after the adjustment. Very simple, very clean, basically looks just like Shopify, more or less. I have the shipping data hidden right now because I don't actually have it set up because this is a playground, but your shipping costs will show up in this section as well. And I'll show you how that works here in a little bit, but this is just a much better user interface. It's clean. It's easy to follow. It tells you what your checkouts are accepted. If you're curious in how this works, it should more or less extract them from the payment gateway. I set up the Stripe payment gateway and PayPal, and that's the only gateways that I have, but these should just generally fit most websites. My general recommendation is you should have Stripe set up to take payment confirmation by directly on your website by inserting the credit card number, and then PayPal, and then anything else is just ancillary. And then the checkout page on the existing WooCommerce website looks kind of like this. It's again, very ugly. It's basic, hard to follow. The spacing is all over the place and it just doesn't look all that nice. This is what it looks like after. It's super clean. It's easy to follow. All the information is easily discernible and it just looks really good. And if you have Apple Pay or Google Pay set up through Stripe, it'll actually show a express checkout button at the top. And I'm going to show you how this all works here in just a minute. It's actually really simple. It relies on the WooCommerce Blocks plugin, which is a totally free plugin that's being worked on by WooCommerce. Expect this to be set up and implemented in WooCommerce Core somewhere down the line, but for now you do need to install WooCommerce Blocks separately. You'll install it and it basically just adds blocks to the Gutenberg editor. If you're using Classic Editor, you'll have to go into your writing settings and allow you to use the Gutenberg editor and change the Classic Editor to it so that way you gain access to the block. But after you gain access to the block, it's really simple to do. All you have to do is, we're going to edit to the new cart page, is you have to add the cart block. And when you edit the cart block, you insert this new block and this is what it's going to show you. It's going to allow you to also view it as an empty cart. So this is what it shows if you have no products. And this is what it'll show you if you have products. These are just randomly generated to show you what it will look like. And as you can see, it does calculate the shipping costs. And you can actually customize some items on the right-hand side. And they are accepting feedback of what you think should be added or some flexibility that you may need on here. So I do highly suggest you give feedback if you're trying to use this for your own website. But for most people, this is really all you need. It shows the information clearly, and it allows them to easily check out without needing to scroll, and it just presents it in such a nice way. There is the shipping calculator option right here, so you'll allow the customers to estimate shipping when they enter their address. You can allow it here. If you just turn it off, it will not allow them to change the address, and then you could choose to hide the address cost until the address has been entered, which is a standard WooCommerce behavior. And then naturally, of course, you could change the proceed to checkout button to link to a specific page. Maybe you're experimenting with the different checkout process, so you could have two separate cart pages and try to do an A/B test to see how it works. But for now, I would just leave it at whatever the checkout page is set to in the WooCommerce settings. Now, the cart page is really basic. The fun one is the checkout page. And as I mentioned, right at the top, big bold express checkout using Apple Pay. For us Android users here, Google Pay would be nice, at least to add in the demonstration. But you know, that's fine. We will let the Apple fanatics get to their day. But you do get a lot of flexibility in this checkout page, which honestly saves people a lot of time. One of the things that's kind of annoying about the default WooCommerce checkout process is it's hard to remove fields, and sometimes the fields are just redundant. And this streamlines it very easy. Your first one is the contact info, and this is required. Anything that's not marked as optional is required, and you can change certain fields to be required, notably a company name, and you could choose to hide the company name altogether if you wish. The phone field can be hidden, but personally, I would suggest you leave it. That way you have a way of contacting your customers. You can mark it as required, and that removes the optional text. And you can choose to remove the secondary address line for like an apartment or suite number. Don't do that. I don't recommend doing that. It's definitely a standard practice now to just have two lines, one with the apartment information and one with the street address. Sometimes people do put it on one line, but most people have now gotten into the habit of it needs to be on two lines, and that's just how most stores are, so I wouldn't change that personally, but if you want a cleaner layout, you most certainly can. Under your navigation options, though, you could choose to show links to your terms and conditions and privacy policy. This is another thing that a lot of plugins kind of filled in the gap on, and WooCommerce Core kind of integrated it for the privacy page, but it's nice that you actually get to see it and that it's down there. My only gripe with this is I feel like the terms and conditions should kind of be somewhere above. It should show up somewhere other than in the footer where you can't read. A lot of people in checkout do require that users click and accept the terms and conditions. And it doesn't look like currently it's not that easy. You could go here and you could follow the settings to set a terms and conditions page. And I'll show you what that does. So we're gonna come over here and we're gonna set it. We're gonna reload. And we set our terms and conditions, but as you can see, it just stuck it right next to the bottom, next to the privacy policy. So it didn't really do anything, which is a shame. And the demo here will show you payment gateways you've added, but it may not always be 100% accurate. So for instance, the PayPal button kind of looks like it's supposed to be for the PayPal Express gateway, but this is just the PayPal standard gateway. The payment information that it puts up there is just random. It's just a random number. It's just to illustrate what it does. The shipping information, you can configure your shipping options using a combination of plugins. I will be making a video down the line of how to do shipping because it's a very complex setup. The coupons code, you can't turn it off. You can't really modify anything other than this block. This is one downside of this implementation, is it's not all that flexible. But over the old system, it's infinitely more flexible and it just looks better. Really, it's just an overall improvement. And because you're able to add it to a page, you can add a bit of flexibility. For instance, on this checkout page, I just have this right here. I could add a cover photo if I wanted to be inserted above and say like, let's see, like add a block before, whoops, meant to make that before, not after. There we go. And we are going to make this block a cover photo. And you could just style a very simple checkout page using, wow, I only imported like the most basic images. You could just style a very nice looking cover photo and just says, thank you for being a... And you can modify it a little bit, set up a basic gradient, and along with your brand scheme, like something like this, modify the angle just a little bit. Okay. And you can just make it very flexible when it was previously very inflexible. And what's great is if your theme is like Genesis or any real decent theme nowadays, you can set the page layout to be full width. And honestly, this is just such an improvement overall. I'm very glad to see it. I highly recommend you play around with this. This is a good introduction to the block editor, mostly because it's a very simple layout. Checkout pages are really just the one checkout box and maybe the header image like I just showed right there. This is a good way to introduce yourself to the block editor, to get familiar with it, and maybe use it for some other simple pages. But overall, this was just a quick guide on how to make your style, your checkout, and your cart pages look a little bit more like Shopify. If you have any questions about the implementation, maybe you have a question about how your theme was working with it, you can ask in the comments below. I'll try to help you out. But a lot of it does come down to the themes and how well they support the block editor. But I will try to help you out. Make sure you like and subscribe, and I'll see you in the next one.